people ask me many questions. People ask me questions like, why should we live? People ask questions, how can we be happy? People ask so many questions. How can we overcome problems? How can we escape from the cycle of death and rebirth? People ask so many questions. But at least what I feel good is that they ask questions. There are another lot who don't ask. They just live and they die. They are like dead fish. A dead fish can float downstream. You can just go on floating and floating and floating. But who are you? Why are you here? What is the purpose of life? If you are suffering, why you are suffering? If something is wrong, is happening, why it is happening? Is there a way to realize God? Who is God? Where is God? What is God? Should I go to the temple and church? Which temple should I go? Which God should I pray? Should I pray? Why should I pray? To whom should I pray? What should I say? You know how many questions are there? Hundreds. The questions are hundreds. That's why we have Ask Care every day. The questions are hundreds. There is no shortage in questions. If you want to ask questions, you can continue through the night, and night after night, you can ask questions. What is karma? Who controls karma? What happens in karma? Who dies? Who is reborn? How you are reborn? Where is the soul? What happens to the soul? Where does the soul go after death? Does the soul belong to me? Is other good souls and bad souls? Oh, there are 100 questions on souls. Does the soul become a ghost after death? What happens at death? Is death the end? What happens to the person who dies? Where does the person go? Does he go to heaven and hell? Where is heaven and hell? Which flight is there? Is there a space shuttle that goes to heaven and hell? Will I meet God? What will God be able to say? How will I be able to see God if I don't have eyes? Will I be given new eyes? What is the meaning of resurrection? What is the meaning of punarjanam? What is the meaning of kayamat kadin? So many things we are taught. We have to unlearn many things. We have to unlearn many things because what we have learned is a lie. Many things that we have learned is a lie. They are lies. Like I told you all, your birthday is not your birthday. I told you your ID card, everything is fake. Therefore, when you come for this call, Ask Air, prepare. Prepare an interesting question that will take us all forward. We all have to go. Forward, onward, upward, Godward. We all have to move up and we have to reach the divine. This is required if you want to live a life of peace, if you want to live a life of bliss and happiness. Otherwise, you will also be like one ordinary person who will live and struggle and die. And you will not know why. And you will not understand who am I. So we must ask. We must investigate. We must realize. Administrator, who's?
No questions.
My God. I already told you 100 questions. So who's going to ask questions today? Bridget, in the soul, but who is the soul? Where is it? Give me Bridget's question, please.
Who is this soul? Where is it?
Bridget, you are the soul. The soul is everywhere. The soul is not from someplace. The soul is eternal. It is immortal. It doesn't die. The soul is a power. You are that power. You are the power of God. You are the power of the divine. You appear as Bridget. Somebody called you Bridget. You think you are a woman who lives in Quebec. But actually, you are the divine soul.
Yes, but where I go, the soul, when we go, when we get die, where go the soul?
When you take a balloon, you take a balloon and you blow the balloon and you burst the balloon, where does the air go?
Everywhere.
The soul is also everywhere. Exactly. Can you catch the air? Can Bridget catch the air? You can't catch the air. Can you catch the soul? You can't catch the soul. Just you have an example. You have an example in front of you that the balloon will burst. Your body will also burst. The body is carrying that energy as long as it is alive in the body. Mm-hmm. Correct? You know, Bridget, can anybody escape death?
No.
Everybody will die.
Yes.
Everybody mm-hmm. will die, right?
Yes.
But you will not die. You will fly. You will fly mm-hmm. in the sky. But you have got two options, Bridget. When you die, the soul has two options. If you do not realize, if you do not get the enlightenment that you are the soul, then you will come back. You will come back, if not to Quebec, you will come back to Africa, or you will come back to America. No, I am warning you, Africa, because you know how it is in Africa, right? So you, when you hear Africa, I say, no, I don't want to go to Africa. So the point is, we want to go and become one with God. We want to become one with the divine. How can mm-hmm. we become one with the divine?
The next question, it's about what I have listening yesterday.
Yeah.
Those who get enlightenment see two suns. What is that?
Those who get enlightenment?
Yeah.
Sing a song.
The song. This soleil, sun.
What song I told yesterday?
What song? Sun.
I tell so many songs.
Sun. Sun.
Sun. Sun.
Sun. Soleil.
Sun.
Those who, they see two sun.
Sun. Yes.
No, why they see two sun? The sun inside comes alive. They don't see two sun.
Yes, I will show you the link. I will send you the link.
Okay. I have a very bad memory. I don't remember anything. Okay. We will look at your question. I will check to find out. I'm sure somebody will help before the session is over. Somebody will find out, Ruchika, or somebody find out what was this I told. Yes, Sudeep, you remember?
Is it that example that you give that sun has multiple reflections? You put two buckets, there will be two suns in the bucket.
But yesterday, she said, I told you.
No, it was not yesterday. But you normally take that example that you see as many suns as the number of buckets. So sun is a reflection.
It was not yesterday, Bridget. Was it yesterday?
No, I don't see yesterday. Okay. I have listening something.
Okay, let me find out. Because we speak.
I will send you.
Send me the link. Because, send me the link. And then we will explain to you. Thank you, Bridget.
Thank you.
Sudeep Bhargava, your question.
Yeah, Shivam, sir. Shivam.
Shivam.
Sir, I wanted to know what could be the different ways of the purification, which is your step number one, purification, liberation, and then unification.
Purification, illumination.
Illumination. Okay. Sorry, I missed one. So what could be the steps of this purification stage? What steps can we take at this point of time?
There are many steps. But if you want an organized step, the organized step for you is Shat Sampat. Sama, Dama, Uparati, Titiksha, Shraddha, Samadhana. Which is control of the mind, control of the senses, control of cravings, faith, forbearance, and focus. These are the six, they call it Samadha. They call these the Shat Sampat, if you would like to follow, right? But let me tell you, I don't believe in these technical things. Let me be more practical with you. So how do you get purified, Sudeep? Sudeep will get purified if Sudeep is able to make the monkey mind into a monk. If you can calm the mind, if you can get your mind to be peaceful, then you don't have that junk. You make the monkey into a monk, then there is no junk. So your monkey, which is jumping, thought. Because what is the cause of the pollution? You want to purify, correct? What do you want to purify? You want to purify all the rubbish in yourself. Who's causing this rubbish? the body, the mind, and the ego. The body, the five senses. I had coffee. I had 20, 30, 40 coffees. I got acidity. I'm having 6 lemons per day. What do you expect? 6 lemons per day. Crazy. But the body wants it. The body created the junk, the poison. Now we have to purify that. So you learn to control your body. You learn to control your mind. The mind is jumping from thought to thought to thought to thought. You catch the monkey. You tie down the monkey. And you stop the I business. The big problem, I am Sudeep. I want this. Try, whenever you say I, stop and say, who's this I? Who wants? So you start saying Sudeep wants. It may look sound very funny, right? Imagine telling your wife, Sudeep wants a cup of tea. Yeah, but that's the way to purify yourself, because you want to realize I am not I. Remember the book we wrote? We wrote a book. It's called I Am Not I. So that is the purification. Purification, how would we all talk about the soul? How Bridget just now spoke. Bridget said, I want the soul. How do you reach the soul? You reach the soul when you drop the body, you drop the mind, you drop the ego. What's left? The soul. That is purification. Purification, when you see the soul, it's illumination. Purification leads to illumination. What is the illumination, Sudeep? The soul. The soul illuminates. The soul is a bright light. The light of the truth. So that comes with first purification. I gave an example yesterday. If the mirror has a thick layer of dust, can you see the reflection? You cannot see. You clean the mirror. How do you clean the mirror? In the sense of the body. You can't go and wash your face with soap and wash your head with shampoo. It's no use. It doesn't help you. You put a lot of perfume. No use. What is the use of putting perfume on the skin? You are not the skin. You are the power within. You get there. Anything else with it?
No, sir. I'll come back to you, sir. I'll think over it.
Thank you. Next question, please.
Veena.
Veena Karate. Veena.
Namaste, Master.
Namaste.
Master, can we decide our rebirth? Means my question is, if we didn't get enlightened or something, can we decide our rebirth?
Very good question. Yes, you can, to a certain extent. What is that extent? You can decide whether you will go to heaven or hell when you come back to earth. No, not heaven and hell in the sky. Whether you will be born happy or unhappy, whether you will be born miserable or you will be born in a rich family or happy, well-to-do family, this will depend upon the deeds that you plant. So, Veena, if you plant good deeds, you are controlling your rebirth to that extent.
Oh.
But you cannot decide, okay, God, I will serve all the food beggars in the street. I should be born in London. Can you tell God like that? No, you cannot control. You cannot say, God, I am going to be vegetarian for the rest of my life. But when I am born, my father and mother should be Chinese. No, you cannot control. But you can control only up to this level. Whether you will be happy or unhappy, you can control. How you can control? If your deeds are good, you will be happy. Today, people who are suffering, why they are suffering? Because their deeds were bad. Today, why there is a thorn in the root? Why there is a thorn on the tree? Because we planted the thorns. If we had planted roses, we would have got roses. If we had planted tulips, we would have got tulips.
Yes, Master.
So, Veena, you can control your destiny up to this point. If you do good things, Veena, if you from this moment onwards, you keep on doing good, keep on doing good, keep on doing good, you control your destiny, your life will be good.
Thank you, Master.
Thank you. Next. Ashok Chotwani.
Shivam, sir.
Shivam, Ashok.
Sir, I have written the question, sir.
You written? Okay, let me read it. Ashok Chotwani's question is, while sitting in silence, transcend our mind, if we talk with our divine soul regarding our enlightened process, is it counted in silence? Yes. If you are able to, if you are in silence, Ashok, in silence, yes. If you are not wandering, if you are not wandering in a material world, if you are not wondering in about what food you are going to eat, what dress you are going to wear, which person you are going to go partying with, which whiskey you are going to drink. You understand when I talk about the material world. But yes, in yes, sitting yes. in silence, if you talk to the divine, which means that you are actually engaged with God, engaged with the soul, engaged with enlightenment. It is not silence, but it becomes more than silence. It takes you beyond, it takes you to introspection. So that is a beautiful thing to do. But the point, the challenge is only this. There's a big challenge. When you are doing that, slowly, slowly, the mind will escape and take you somewhere else. You please try and tell me whether it's true or false.
Okay, sir.
As you're trying to talk to the soul, and you're talking to the soul, and you're saying, oh, I should be enlightened, and you know, I am very keen. I want to know neti neti tattvamasi, and I don't want to be reborn. And as you're thinking and talking to the soul, then the mind will come and say, but what about corona? But what about COVID vaccine? You have not taken vaccine. This is how the mind will come. And when the mind takes you to the next point, then it will take you somewhere else and somewhere else and somewhere else. So you have to be very careful. What I'm saying?
Yeah. But sir, for following the process, I am talking with soul. Yeah.
Yeah. Provided you don't break that talking. Provided you don't let the mind come and disturb you. Provided you are conscious. Provided you are ready to stop the mind. If it comes, hey, show, stop. No, I don't want you to come and talk about it. The mind will, if the mind comes, say, show. God, quiet. I want to talk to my soul. Like that.
Thank you, sir.
Next question. Gautam.
Shivam.
Shivam.
Sir, I want to know about what is the meaning, what is the difference between being in silence and doing meditation? Are both the same equal? Because when I be in silence and when I do meditation, it feels me with the both are same. I'm a little bit confused what to do.
No, they both are very similar. Basically, see, meditation is a little more than silence. Silence, for example, now I am just silent. But in meditation, normally we are trying to contemplate on something. We are contemplating on a mantra, or we are contemplating on a thought, an analogy, like Ashok Chotwani said about talking to the soul. Silence is a part of meditation. Meditation makes the mind silent. So they both are very close to each other. But what is your confusion, Gautam? Don't be confused about these words. What do you want to get to?
Because when I be in silence, my thoughts will be coming. Something to see beautiful things and to see temple, to see God. But in meditation, when I do meditation, the same thoughts again comes. No difference about it.
So you're right. See, when you're silent, it's not that the mind is silent, right? But in meditation, you try to quieten the mind. You make an effort in meditation to silence, to make the mind stop jumping. So, where I am concerned, what you do, Gautam, you please try to be silent, and you also try to do meditation. When you try to do meditation, you use a mantra. For example, where you are concerned, you may say Shivoham, Shivoham. You may say that, or you may say Om, 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 Om. Meditation is a method where you may not be silent. In meditation, you may not be silent.
Yeah, yeah.
Many meditations, they will keep on saying, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. There's a meditation. But is it really meditation? So many people have a different way of saying different things. But where you are concerned, What is the way? I'm just giving you what is important. One, silence is very important. Silence means just switching off. Shh. And meditation is to calm the mind. A meditation is when the mind is jumping here and there, you make a conscious effort to calm the mind. In silence, you don't make any effort. In silence, you are just still. Okay, Gautam, you try out these two and see how it works.
Okay. And if I have any doubts, I'll call you. I'll again ask you.
Please ask.
I'm still not getting confused. I'm not confused still.
No, see, because you are asking the difference of two things.
Because I'm feeling the same in meditation. I'm being silent. The same thoughts I'm getting and same thing I'm feeling it. I'm not having any difference about it.
So are you using in meditation? Are you using a mantra or you're not using a mantra?
No, I'm not using.
Then that is silence. Are you able to stop the mind? You're not able to stop the mind.
But when I do meditation, I'll think as put in a YouTube. I'll put a flute music. Huh. So my mind goes to beautiful places and river, mountains. I feel like these parks.
That is not meditation. That is relaxation.
Oh, relaxation.
That is not meditation. Meditation means to make the mind still, make the mind completely thoughtless. That is the aim of meditation. It is consciousness, mindfulness.
Okay.
That is meditation. So I have given the answer. You think about it.
Okay. Okay. Next. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Sharma. My dear
Shivoham, sir.
Mr. Sharma. Shivoham.
Sir, what are the attributes for the soul, sir?
The soul has no attributes.
No attributes.
Now, if you want, your attributes means it has certain qualities. When you are saying
those qualities,
but what we know about the soul, what we know about the soul, we cannot call it attributes. But let us say, what do we know about the soul? The soul is birthless. The soul is deathless. The soul is a power. The soul is an energy. The soul is God. If you want to call these attributes, you call them attributes.
What about joy and knowledge, sir?
Joy
and knowledge.
The knowledge of a human being is nothing compared to
nothing.
The soul is omniscient. Omniscient means it knows everything. If you ask right now how many stars are there in the universe, the soul knows. But the soul is beyond man's comprehension. We are not able to comprehend the soul or God. We only know, for example, it's trying to define God. How to define God?
Omniscient, omnipresent, and.
So, for example, you are saying, you ask joy. Soul is Ananda, Satchit Ananda. We know this. Yeah. It is the highest level of Ananda. But that is the Jeev Atma realizing the soul. Actual soul Ananda will be more than Satchit Ananda. Because the soul doesn't have Satchit. That Satchit is only for Krishna Sharma. When you are in the body, the soul, when it's not in the body, it is even beyond that. We cannot imagine. It's like me telling you how many liters of water in Indian Ocean. How to say, Krishna Sharma, how many liters of water in Indian Ocean?
We can't say.
Like that. The soul is limitless. It is not even required for us to think. Krishna Sharma, what we can experience, I can tell you, is Sat Chit Anand. That itself is so beautiful. It is so blissful that there is no problem in the world at all. There is no fear. There is no worry. You do not mind to die now. You are not worried about poverty. You are not worried about health, heart attack. You are not worried about heartbreak. You don't care whether somebody loves you or don't love you. You don't worry about what food is there or not. There is nothing to worry. That state of Sat Chit Anand, that itself is such a beautiful state. Satyam Shivam Sundaram. When you feel Satyam Shivam Sundaram, every morning I see God. When I wake up, a small bird will come in. I see God in the morning. First thing in the morning, I see God. Then I come to the leaves, I come to the trees. When you reach that state, no Krishna Sharma, that itself is very high. Beyond that is the soul. Now, beyond that, we cannot fathom how much, how deeply that soul is knowledge and joy and bliss is beyond our imagination. We cannot imagine.
Thank you, sir.
Sure. Thank you. Next. Sachin. Yes, Sachin.
Shivoham, sir.
Shivoham.
I just wanted to know if everything is God, then do we as a soul has any unique identity? Like if we are like, you say, balloon full of air, then that air which is filled in that balloon, does it have any unique identity or it will just merge in, diffuse air or atmosphere?
Who you're talking about, who has identity? You as Sachin or the soul or a balloon or air?
Me as a soul. Me as Atma and Sachin.
You as Atman, your identity is everything. So you are America. You are Antarctica. You are the mountains. You are the ocean. You are the skies. You are the cloud. It is from you that everything comes. From you, the flowers come. The birds come. The waters come. The winds come. The rain comes. The snow comes. It is from you. Provided you realize that you are that you.
But won't that lead to sort of a superiority emotion in ourselves, like we are like superpower or something like that?
How? When you know that we are nothing and that power is God and that God is everything, we are just a manifestation. You will submit, you will immediately surrender. There is no ego. The superiority comes from whom? The superiority comes from the ego. When you know the ego is an illusion, the ego doesn't exist. The ego is a monster.
Yes.
When you realize that, Sachin, see, enlightenment drops all these superiority complexes. It drops fear. It drops everything. And it makes us realize it. What you will feel, you will feel you and me are one. I'm sorry. You will feel today the problem. I was just reading the news just today. Some terrorist went into Kashmir, one man's house, and shot him dead yesterday, and shot his mother and shot his wife. Shot them dead. Tell me why.
Because of his mind and ego, maybe.
Because of ignorance. Because they don't know that they are the Atma. They don't realize that they are killing themselves. They don't realize that they are creating new karma. They don't realize they have been told that they will be given Jannat and they will go to Jannat and they will be given... No, but this is foolishness. This is being fooled by the other terrorists and teaching them wrong things. And when teaching them wrong things, they are doing wrong things. This is ignorance. And ignorance is a very dangerous thing. When we are ignorant, we are doing all the wrong things. For example, we are trying to keep more money. And what will we do with money, Sachin? We know the money will not be ours. You see, people, they are buying one property, second property, 10 properties, one plane, second plane, 10 ships. Sachin, yes. Don't even an idiot knows, right? Nothing belongs to us. Even an idiot knows it, right? Then why we are doing this? We are doing this because of ignorance. We have to overcome our ignorance. That superiority complex also will come only when we believe that I am I. When we realize I am not I. I am not the name I was given. I am not this body. I am not the mind. I am the Atma. Atma is Paramatma. I am that Paramatma. When we reach that state, oh my God, then there is no superiority. What is there to be? How can, does the right hand try to have superiority over the left hand? Does the right eye try to be superior over the left eye?
No, sir.
Why not?
Because it knows they are the same.
They are the same. So the same answer, Sachin. When you reach that state of enlightenment, you know everything is the same. You don't have any superiority. You just surrender.
But sir, more question. If
yes,
like soul is, we are God, matlab ansh of God, ansh of God, whatever. Then the God is so strong. Then why these vices, this ignorance and this mind and ego, they become heavier over the matlab, like the power of God? If God is so strong and he's inside us, then shouldn't these things be overcome like by that strong power?
So that God is in you, but you have forgotten that God is in you. That's why. The moment you don't need to do anything, you just need to drop these layers of ignorance. You just have to drop the body, drop the mind, drop the ego, nothing. You just have to drop it. And you will shine like God. You don't need anything.
That's the challenge, sir.
That is the challenge. That's the challenge because of our ignorance. Because we have been taught wrong things. We have been taught success is important. We have been taught you cheat also. We have been taught taking somebody. You know something? Yes. I went to eat Pani Puri. So we ate Pani Puri. It is 40 rupees per plate. So we ate Pani Puri. I think we ate from 5 plates or something like that. So the man said 160 rupees. So my friend gave 160 rupees and took 40 rupees change and was going.
Yes.
So I told that Pani Puri wala, how 160 rupees? 5 plates into 40 rupees, 200 rupees.
Mm-hmm.
So he said, nahi sir, I do not remember you eaten 5 plates. I thought you eaten only 4 plates.
Mm-hmm.
My friend got angry with me. He said, hey, what, man? Why? He's a fool, man. He's 160 rupees. Why you are giving 200 rupees? He took only 160. My friend started fighting with me.
So that's but human nature.
You've seen all this story. What else you have seen, right? See,
yes,
this is the problem. How many times you have gone to a restaurant and you have eaten one makhanwala and 2 naans. And along with that, you had one Pepsi. But in the bill, he did not put the Pepsi. How many times it happens? Many times.
Yes.
Most of us, quietly we'll pay the bill. We will not talk about the Pepsi and we will walk out.
Yes, yes.
This is our ignorance. Now you tell me, you may say it is very difficult. No, I'm not saying it is difficult. It is very easy to tell that man, my dear friend, you're not charged for my Pepsi.
Mm-hmm.
This is being the God you're talking about. Mm-hmm. For you to be the God inside you, you have to drop all this ignorance, all this dirt we have to drop. And I have gone through all this many times in my life. But when the realization comes, I'm taking Pepsi money from one poor waiter. I'm taking 40 rupees from one Pani Puri fellow. What a fool I am. Then that realization will not make us do anything wrong.
Thank you, sir. Shivam, sir. Thank you. Shivam, sir.
Thank you. Lakshmi. Yes, Lakshmi. Last question for today. Lakshmi. Tell me,
Shivam,
I can hear you.
I actually told the word that there should not be an ego, right? To a person. I think if somebody opposite person is scolding us, obviously we feel very angry and we give back them. Even somebody calls that is an ego. I think it is not a bad thing, right?
It is not a bad thing if you are living a normal life. But if you want to be God, if you want to realize God, then you realize it is just like when Gabbar Singh is shouting from the screen, you also get up in the theater and you shout back, hey, Gabbar, hey, you also shout back in the screen. If you are shouting at somebody in the theater, then it's foolishness. No, because everything is a drama. That person shouting at you, you have to ignore it. Why you should react to it? Let that person shout. Why you lose your peace of mind? So that is the way of spirituality. Spirituality is not reacting because we cannot control other people's action, but we can control our reaction. Therefore, in spirituality, we learn to control our reaction. We don't try to control other people's action because we cannot. We cannot control other people's action, but we can control our reaction. So, my dear friends, thank you, Lakshmi.
Okay. Thank you, sir. That was my doubt. That's it.
Yeah. So please don't react, because the right thing to do is ignore that. If somebody throws dirty coins at you, and you don't take those dirty coins belong to whom? It belongs to that person. Threw it. Let that person throw the dirty things. You let them take it back. You ignore it. You walk on. My dear friends, every day you'll have coming up with very interesting questions, but don't hesitate to ask anything that has a doubt, that you have a doubt on, because in this journey, we have to overcome ignorance and realize the truth. It is not an easy journey. It is like going to Mount Everest. We have to work hard, but the result, the reward is fantastic. I can tell you, because I have been rewarded the bliss of Sat Chit Anand. I enjoy that peace, that bliss, that joy, no matter what. And I would like to share that with you every day at 8. I bow down and I thank you.